Hello, anybody, if you're reading whatever is left, welcome back to... Welcome to, for the first time, Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic. And that was your basic reading lessons with Toemor. Goodbye, everyone. See you next year. I expect an essay on those, six words on my desk Monday morning next year. So, good luck. But aside from that, hello everyone. I am here. We are playing. We are going to play, or I am going to play. You're going to watch, or listen to, or just be in remote distance. I don't know. You're probably listening to and or watching this if you're listening to me right now. So, yeah. Whatever, that was odd. Knights of the Old Republic, KOTOR, we are doing this. We are doing this, yes. And we are not going to go to movies, because we've got some stuff that is in... Can I see every movie in this? I have no idea if I can see all the movies. It might just be every movie that I've seen. Yeah, that's probably true, because I got to Leviathan the first time I played this, and then the game crashed. It got to, like, a fail state where I couldn't play anymore, because the game just kept crashing, and then I just never touched it again until many years later. And then stuff happened. But anyway, moving on. We're going to be, Oh, by the way, I have, I think three mods on, installed. One called, I think it's called Suleiman's Revenge, or something along those lines, but I don't think it happens until, like, after the main campaign. I don't know if we'll even get to that. Maybe, maybe not. But, when you load in the mod, you get to start with a save from that mod. I don't know what I've done with that save, because I didn't see it when I clicked loading, when I accidentally clicked load game earlier. But we also have, I have no idea what this mod's called, but it adds a whole bunch of new force powers, which is really freaking great. It also adds the ability to use the six different lightsaber combat forms. Well, you don't really... Well, use them, I guess, is probably a limitation of the game, because you use it and it's like a buff for like a minute or something. When in actuality, I think it'd probably be more like how it works in SWTOR, where it's just like a stance type thing. But anyway, and the final mod that I can recall I have installed is... Well, crap. It's a Skip Terrace mod. Yeah, it's Skip Terrace. Terrace, Taurus, whatever you... I don't know. I call it Terrace. I think they call it Terrace in-game, too. Or they pronounce it Terrace. Either or. We're not going to skip Terrace. Taurus? No, it's Taurus, not Terrace. I feel so stupid now. But anyway, moving on to characters. If I went soldier, I'd go invincible. Yeah, let's go for soldier. Let's become the raid boss, the invincible raid boss. We get to pick our heads. This guy always looked weird because his like hair was all weird looking right there. But we're gonna be who looks like a raid boss here? Gonna be like someone who looks kind of evilly. Yeah, this guy looks kind of evil. He's got the scar and the soul patch. Yeah, raid patch. Yeah. Great. I forget what these are all for. Let's see. Charisma. It'll be useful for Mr. Main Character. What's high forest point? We don't need a modifier for that. We won't be using. We won't be really using these intelligence. I'd like to get a plus one modifier in that just because it gives us more skill points. Con, and that'll be useful. Dex. Does Dex have any? Oh, it's mostly for blasters, so we'll just take a plus one to that, and then we can get a plus one to this. And can we get a plus four? No, we need 3 points for that. We can't pump Connor's strength, which are our power stats, because we're going to be the raid boss of invincibility. We can put Intel on the verge of getting a plus two. I don't remember if attribute points, how often you get these. Let's put it in charisma. Why not? No, screw that. We don't need charisma. Whoops. Did not mean to go back that far. Great. Dropping down Dex. That. Intel and that. We don't need con. We need very much con. We don't need charisma. Put it all in strength. Can I put everything in strength? Oh, I can't get it past 18. Yeah, we're gonna suck at basically everything but hitting. We got a plus 4 to hit. That's really freaking good for level 1. What about con? Wisdom. We're gonna suck at everything. I don't care. We're gonna suck at everything, but we will be the invincible raid boss. I actually don't know how much of defensive rating you get from Dex. Whatever. Okay, for soldier, I don't like the recommended for skills, because for soldiers it usually just pumps everything and it treat injury. We don't need demolition. We can get a demo man later. Persuasion. I could put points in this, and I usually always put points in this because you can get some useful stuff from this, but seeing as how I basically just said screw everything that doesn't make me invincible, putting points in this would just be a waste, because I think we've got like a minus two modifier for charisma. Oh, good. Yeah, we don't really have any attributes that would like we could do anything with skills, because I've got like minuses for everything except con and strength. I think I have like I don't think I get a modifier for intelligence. So we'll go with, I actually have no idea. This is usually really simple, because I just like max persuasion, and then I just put it in like, how many do I get? 12 max persuasion, maybe, and then max like two other skills like computer, but I can't do that now. Well, I could, but it'd be a waste. We'll go with something at intelligence. How about we'll go with demolitions? Why not? We can be a demo man. An awareness, we won't be the best at awareness, we won't be the best at anything, we'll be pretty crappy at everything except like not dying. Sure, this'll do. It'll be the strangest character I've made, because it's the first time I've just pumped ignored every stat, but like pumping and pumped two. And this is where we get to be interesting. We're gonna go with two weapon fighting. And I'm not really a fan of how this game does two-weapon fighting. Or at least what this game considers two-weapon fighting, because if you're unaware, this game considers dual wielding, which is using a weapon in both hands, the same as using a pole arm, which is using like a saber staff or like a double-sided lightsaber like Darth Maul. It considers those the same thing, and I'm not really a fan of that, but it means I can just max out two-weapon fighting, and then I can just switch between two lightsabers or freaking a double-billed lightsaber, which we will get sometime in the future, I think. Even if I have to steal one from someone, I'm gonna get it. And we're gonna be, Toemor. That's some me. So here we go. This is gonna be great. I can't wait to see how everyone just hates me for my freaking 8 charisma. Oh god. Game? You still with me? You still with me, game? Did you crash? Little crash? Did that happen? Okay. Hello. Yes, we are back. Game crashed during the loading screen. So I had to... Which, by the way, that meant none of this was saved. So I had to go back and remake Toemor, the Invincible Raid Boss. And I don't know where... I don't know what I did, but I messed up the attribute distribution somehow, because I ended up with... four extra skill points, which I guess means I got an extra plus one on my... I got a plus one modifier on my intel. So... I saved those 4 points, because we're not going to spend them in anything but those 3 skills, because we're not freaking going to... We're not going to be soaring through on attribute, on skills, especially because we're a soldier who I think they get feats really quick, but they don't get skills very often. I think that's how that works. I don't remember what the other two get. I know one of them gets like skills very often, but they don't get feats very often. The other one, I think, is just like a balance, like they get skills and feats the same frequency. I think that's how it works. I might have that backwards. No, soldiers should get feats more often, because they don't get skill. Whatever, I don't know. I'm pretty sure soldiers get feats more often, but we've remade my character, and you would not believe the hoops I've just had to been jumping through for the last 20 minutes, because the game kept crashing every time when I hit play on new game, or load game, or whatever. Every time I tried to get in-game, the game just crashed, and, long story short, it's because when I was messing with audio crap and other settings, I accidentally put a little tick on something that I don't remember the name of, but it basically causes the game to crash on my PC. I'm just going to go ahead and say on newer PCs, because this is kind of an old game, if you're not aware. Oh, good!
Thank you. We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time.
Yes, here we are. We can skip Taurus with the Skip Taurus mod, and we also get to skip the Endar Spire, so we can just go straight to that planet whose name is Dantooine. There we go. I remember. We're not gonna do that, but we could. We can even go like light side, dark side, no side. Isn't there? I thought there was a neutral option. Oh well.
Who's siding you?
I'm Trask Ulgo, ensign with the Republic Fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up! We have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive.
You know, even if we didn't work opposite shifts, we'd still like run into each other when we're like doing shift changes, but whatever.
Bastil is the commanding officer on the Endar Spire. Well, not an officer, really. But she's the one in charge of this mission. One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy attack. You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I've heard all about your reputation. Elite combat training, tops in your class. It's no wonder you were handpicked for this mission. Word is, the officers haven't seen a recruit with your kind of potential in 20 years. But all that potential doesn't mean a thing if you can't deliver when it counts. We're soldiers. We're trained for combat. Bastil is gonna need men and women like us at her side during this attack.
Shoot, man. You like called me out. I gotta do it now. I can't back down.
So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here.
Roger. Freaking naked, man.